Hello students, today we are going to discuss chemistry paper of AIPMT 2014 code number P. So starting with the first question, that is question number 46 of the paper. What is the maximum number of orbitals that can be identified with the following quantum numbers? N is equal to 3, L is equal to 1, M is equal to 0. As you know, any orbital requires 3 quantum number for its description. An electron requires 4 quantum number for its description. Since the question is related to orbital, so the correct answer should be 1, and we can signify that orbital n is equal to 3. So this is third orbital, third shell. L is equal to 1, so this is p orbital. M is equal to 0, so this orbital is 3pz orbital. Next question, question number 47. Calculate the energy in joule corresponding to light of wavelength 45 nanometer. Planck's constant is given, 6.63 into 10 raised to power minus 34 joules second, and speed of light is also given. C is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. So see here, we have to calculate the energy of photon. As we know, energy of photon is equal to h nu, or it can be written E is equal to h C by lambda. Now in this question, H is given. H is Planck's constant, 6.63 into 10 raised to power minus 34 joules second. C is a speed of light, which is 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. In this question, wavelength is also given, and it is given in nanometer. So while we are using this formula, since joules, Planck's constant is given in a standard unit, so we have to convert this wavelength into standard unit of length, that is meter. So 45 nanometer can be written as 45 into 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. And when we solve this question, the value of energy of photon is coming out 4.42 into 10 raised to power minus 18 joules. It means answer of this question will be fourth answer. Next question, question number 48. Equal masses of hydrogen, oxygen and methane have been taken in a container of volume V at temperature 27 degrees centigrade in identical conditions. The ratio of the volumes of gases, hydrogen, oxygen, methane would be. Now see in this question, we are taking three different gases, hydrogen, oxygen and methane. But all the three gases are taken at identical condition. So we know that volume of gas is directly proportional to their number of moles. Now we have to calculate the number of moles. Now in this question, it is mentioned that equal masses of all the three gases is taken. Suppose the mass of gas taken is 32 gram for each gas. So here I am writing 32 gram hydrogen gas, 32 gram for oxygen gas, 32 gram for methane gas. Now in case of hydrogen, number of moles will be 32 by 2, which is equal to 16. While in case of oxygen, mass is given 32, its molecular mass is 32, so this is equal to 1 mole. In case of methane, the mass is given 32 gram, its molecular mass is given 16, so number of moles is 2. Now since the gases are present at the identical condition, their molar ratio is coming out 16 is to 1 is to 2. and whatever will be their molar ratio, that will be directly proportional to the volume ratio. It means volume ratio should be 16:1:2. So correct answer is option number 3. So next question is question number 49. If A is the length of the side of a cube, the distance between the body centered atom and one corner atom in the cube will be. In this question, we have to imagine a perfect cube. And according to question, the atoms are present at the corner as well as at body center. It means we have to find out the distance from a corner atom to body center atom. Now you can see this distance is half of the body diagonal. So it means we have to find out the distance which is half of the body diagonal. For any cubic structure, the body diagonal is equal to √3a. It means the distance between two adjacent atoms of corner and body center position should be √3a/2. So our correct answer is fourth option, √3/2a.